We want to indicate when the first derivative is positive or negative, then indicate the number of critical numbers and any relative extrema. So notice how this is the graph of f prime of x, not f of x. So f prime of x is positive when the graph is above the x-axis, which should be over this interval here from -3 to +4. The derivative function is negative when it's below the x-axis, which should be over this interval here and this interval here. So the first derivative is positive over the open interval from -3 to +4. Now it doesn't ask, but remember this means that the function f of x would be increasing over this interval. And watch you compare the derivative function to the actual function f of x when we finish. And the first derivative is less than 0 or negative over the open interval from -∞ to -3 and over the open interval from 4 to ∞. Remember, if the first derivative is less than 0 or negative, that means the function f of x would be decreasing. Next, we have to determine the number of critical numbers. Critical numbers occur where the first derivative is either undefined or equal to 0. So again, looking at the graph, notice how the first derivative function value is 0 at the x-intercepts here and here. So we have two critical numbers, and the critical numbers are x = -3 and x = +4. And now we're asked to determine the location of any relative max or any relative mins. Well, notice at x = -3, the first derivative changes from -to +, which means the function f of x changes from decreasing to increasing at x = -3, and therefore there would be a low point or a relative minimum. So we have a relative minimum at x = -3. And then notice at x = 4, the derivative function changes sign again. It changes from +to -, which means f of x changes from increasing to decreasing, and therefore f of x would have a high point or relative maximum at x = 4. So we have a relative max at x = 4. So sometimes these questions can be a little tricky because we're so used to analyzing the function, but here we're actually given the derivative function and asked several questions. So to finish, let's go ahead and compare the graph of f of x and the graph of f prime of x on the same coordinate plane. So we have the derivative function graphed here in blue and the original function f of x graphed in red. So first notice where the derivative function is positive, f of x is increasing over this interval here. And where the first derivative is negative, here and here, our function is decreasing here and here. And notice the derivative function is 0 at x = -3. And at x = +4, right where the function changes from decreasing to increasing and increasing to decreasing. Notice that the critical number x = -3, we have a low point or a relative minimum, and at the other critical number x = 4, we have a high point or a relative maximum. I hope you found this helpful.